What is up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. If you guys are new here, welcome. My name is Ilianana. If you guys are already part of this wonderful family, you guys know the drill. Thank you guys so much for continuing to watch and to support. So in today's video, we are going to be reviewing a new foundation on the market. This is the NYX Bear With Me Blurring Tint Foundation. That's a mouthful, but I'm super excited. This literally just launched. So before we take a look into the foundation, make sure that you guys subscribe, like, and comment. Don't forget to turn on your post notifications, and let's just go ahead and dive into one of the last reviews of the year. Let's go. I did pick up mine in the shade 4 Light Neutral. So this is the Bear With Me Blurring Tint Foundation from NYX. Now, I'm going to pull it up here on the website. Now, this is obviously a vegan and cruelty-free brand, so starting off with that. So it does say that it's never going to look cakey or ashy on you. There are really great skin-loving ingredients in this, like niacinamide, matcha, glycerin. All that's gonna just leave your skin looking very blurred and healthy looking. Let's see. It does say that it's available in 24 shades, and it's supposed to be a skin tint that provides 12 hours of hydration and up to 16 hours of wear. Really big claims there. It says that it is suitable for all skin types, including oily, dry, and combination skin. So it's kind of like one for everybody. So sometimes when brands create like a one for everybody type of foundation, it can be hard to just really, you know, meet the criteria of everybody's skin. So I'm very curious to see how it is. Now, I am going to be using the Bear With Me concealer that goes along with the same line, the Bear With Me line here. So I'm going to use these two hand in hand. Let's just go ahead and zoom you guys in and jump into it. I'm gonna go in with my e.l.f. Poreless Putty Primer to prime the skin. I really like this primer. I forgot how much I really loved this. The other day I grabbed it from my vanity and I've just been using it ever since. I do like using a good amount. You probably don't need this much. I just really like the way it leaves my skin. Like I said, this was like my go-to primer for a very long time. And then I completely forgot about it, and I recently rediscovered it, and I've just been using it every single day ever since. But this is what the packaging looks like. It is the Bear With Me Blurring Tint Foundation. So this is, again, 24 shades, retails for $14 at Ulta and on the NYX website. I did get mine from Ulta. They already had like the whole display and everything ready to go. So let's just go in with it. On the back, it does say medium coverage and matte blurred finish. So let's just dive right in. I'm like super excited about this. I've seen it all over Trend Mood and I see people posting about it. So I really, really, really wanted to try it out. Okay. So it looks like it's gonna match. It does have like a thicker consistency for it being like a tint foundation. Let's see. It might be a little warm. That might work, actually. I like applying with my e.l.f. sponge, so that's what I'm going to be doing on this side. And let's just start blending this in. It is pretty light in shade. I probably could have gotten away with a shade deeper, because this is pretty light. I probably could have gotten away with one shade deeper. I might have to exchange it. It's not completely like matte. It kind of looks like a satin matte finish. I'm gonna add a little bit more coverage right there. And I'm gonna just see if we can build up a little bit right there. It comes off really warm, and then I blend it into the skin and it just looks very cool toned, which is weird. So side by side to the other side, obviously I don't have any foundation on this side. And then nice even coverage. It kind of evens out the skin tone. Not full coverage, but it definitely did even out the skin tone, and my pores look pretty good too. So let's start adding a little bit more on the other side. I'm probably gonna end up getting a different shade though, because I'm not a huge fan of this shade. Like it's like it looks like it would match, and then blending it out, it just looks really light. Like you can see it on my forehead. It just looks a little too light. I do like a little bit more of a neutral, warmer undertone in my foundations. So see what I mean? Like it looks warm and then it blends out super cool tone. So even though the shade is slightly off, I do like the finish of it. I like the way it looks on the skin. It looks really nice. And it is giving like a blurred look to the skin too. I feel so pale. It's crazy. Definitely need a different shade for sure. Hopefully on camera it doesn't look that bad, but in person, I look really, really pale. So I'm definitely gonna have to switch it out for a different shade for sure. This is really close. You can see that it looks really good. Like, my skin looks good, and it does have like a satin matte finish. It's not glowy or dewy, but it's definitely not like a completely mattifying foundation. It looks really nice, but again, the shade is slightly off for my skin tone. Okay, so now I'm gonna be going in with the NYX Bear With Me Concealer Serum here. Or not. Am I able to squeeze some out through here? Oh no, I like don't know what happened to it, so I'm gonna have to squeeze some on here and grab it from here. I'm just gonna scoop some up here. And we're gonna just kind of see how this blends together. Again, this is not the most full coverage concealer either. It's more like an everyday light wear, kind of evens out but doesn't create too much coverage. It's like an everyday concealer, nothing for like a full glam or anything. But this is what we're gonna be using because it is from the same line from NYX. So I figured, why not use them both? Concealed one side, and you can definitely see it did what it was supposed to do. Again, it's not a full glam concealer. Oh, I have something in my eye. But it does kind of brighten up the under eye, and you can definitely see the difference in the eyes. So I'm just so upset that I don't have the top. I don't know what happened to it. I haven't used this in such a long time. So far, it's looking pretty good. I mean, I like my complexion. My complexion is looking good. Okay, I'm not mad at my complexion. It's looking good. It's looking smooth and blurred. I have no complaints about it so far. Again, we're gonna have to see how it wears throughout the day. So I'm gonna finish the rest of my face makeup and then we will come back and see the final look so we can see how everything kind of blended in together, and then I'll share my final thoughts. Let's finish up this makeup look and I'll be right back. All right, you guys, so I finished the rest of my makeup and I also applied my lippy for today, and I have to say I'm actually really impressed with the foundation. Like, it is a medium coverage, but it still looks really, really good on the skin. And I'm looking at myself in the mirror up close and my skin actually does really look blurred. Like, my pores look very, very small. They looked blurred. I don't know if it's a combination of the poreless putty primer and this, but even the poreless putty primer by itself doesn't completely diminish pores, but I feel like these two in combination together, my skin looks really like I really do have a filter on my skin. I did take a picture on my front camera with my phone. I'm gonna insert that right here so you guys can see how it looks with no edits, no nothing, and it does look really good on the skin. So I'm very impressed with it. Let me show you guys for you guys to see yourself what it really looks like. So let's zoom you in. Here's my skin. It's looking really good. I mean, look at that. It looks really good. Like, I'm very impressed with this. And again, the only thing, I mean, now the shade, I did bronze like the heck out of my face, but you know, the shade wasn't too bad. Yes, I'm gonna still switch it for a different shade because personally, it's just personal preference, you know. I really do like a different undertone as opposed to the one that this one had. You know, in person, I do look a little pale. On camera, I feel like it looks pretty decent. I'm still gonna be exchanging it for probably one shade up just to see how it works with my skin. But other than that, I really do like it. And again, it was $14. It's still, you know, in a decent range. It is kind of up there, but it is, you know, that one fluid ounce. I really like how it looks. Like, my skin looks so good. Again, we have to see how it wears. We have to see if it transfers, if it smears, if it kind of fades anywhere, anything like that. But I will leave an update down in the description box. I'm gonna be wearing it all night pretty much. It is right now 2:55 in the afternoon. So I am gonna wear it for the rest of the day and I will keep you guys updated in the description box. So make sure that you guys check that out there. I hope that you guys enjoyed today's video and I hope that 2023 brings so much happiness and joy into everyone's life because 2022 was crazy to say the least. So happy new year and I'll see you guys very soon in my next video. Ciao.